In the last video, already I explained up to 10th problem. Now I start the 11th problem. Sum number 11. So the question is, the length of the perpendicular from the point 0, 0 to the straight line passing through the point P1, 2 such that P bisects the intercepted part between the axes. That is, here the question is equal to, we want the length of the perpendicular drawn from origin to the straight line. So this is the origin, this is the straight line. We want the length of the perpendicular. And what is the given data? The line is bisected at the point P1, 2. So by using this condition, first of all, we have to find the equation of the straight line. And after that, we have to take the length of the perpendicular. So what is the formula for finding the equation of the line now? Suppose the line is bisected at the point x1, y1. Then the equation of the line formula, x by x1 plus y by y1 is equals to 2. The line is bisected at the point x1, y1. Then the formula is equal to x by x1 plus y by y1 is equal to 2. That is, replacing the point here, given point is equal to 1, 2. X by 1 plus y by 2 is equal to 2. Taking the LCM, 2x plus 5 is equal to 4. So this is the line equation. Now what is the given question? Length of the perpendicular. The formula for finding the length of the perpendicular, mod c by square root of a square plus b square. That is equals to modulus of minus 4. Writing this constant to this side, minus 4 by square root of 4 plus 1 equal to 5. So answer is equal to 4 by root 5. That is the third option. Sum number 12. Radius of the circle touching the lines 3x plus 4y minus 14 is equal to 0. 6x plus 8y plus 7 is equal to 0. Radius of the circle. Suppose this is the circle. Given data is, the circle touches the two lines. Observe that these two lines are the parallel lines here. So the first line equation is 3x plus 4y minus 14 is equal to 0. And the second line equation is 6x plus 8y plus 7 is equal to 0. Here two parallel lines are given. Since the slopes of the two lines are equal here, observe here, what is the slope of this line? Minus 6 by 8, that is minus 3 by 4. And what is the slope of this line? Minus 3 by 4. Means the slopes are equal. So these two lines are the parallel lines. That is given that the circle touches the two parallel lines. Then what is the radius of the circle? See here, from the diagram clearly here we have that the distance between the parallel lines is nothing but the diameter value, r plus r, 2r. Here from the diagram, we can get the 2r value by taking the distance between the parallel lines. So to find the distance between the parallel lines, we have to equate the first two terms of the both of the equations for applying the formula. That is, first I multiply this equation by 2 here. Then what we get? 6x plus 8y minus 28 is equal to 0. So first, to make the x and y quotients equal, first of all, we have to multiply the second equation by 2. Now taking the distance between the parallel lines. From the diagram, what is the distance between the parallel lines here? 2r. 2r is equal to. Now what is the formula for finding the distance between the parallel lines? Modulus of c1 minus c2 by square root of a square plus b square. That is, modulus of c1 is equal to 7. C2 is equal to minus 28. Minus of minus plus 28 by square root of 36 plus 64. A square B square, 36 plus 64, that is equals to 100, that is 35 by 10, that is 2R is equal to 35 by 10, means this is 7 by 2, therefore the value of R is equal to 7 by 4, that is the third option, R is equal to 7 by 4. Sum number 13, The distance between the parallel lines given by x plus 7y whole square plus 4 root 2 into x plus 7y minus 42 equal to 0. First, taking the expansion, taking the simplification of the given equation, x plus 7y whole square, taking the expansion, x square plus 14xy plus 49y square plus, multiplying the terms here, first value 4 root 2x plus next value 28 root 2y plus minus 42 is equal to 0. Now this is a given equation. Now what is the formula for finding the distance between the parallel lines? 2 root g square minus ac by a into a plus b. Now replacing the values, what are abc values? A is equal to 1 here, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 49, c is equal to minus 42. And what is g value? 2g is equal to 4 root 2. 2g is equal to 4 root 2 means g is equal to 2 root 2. Now replacing the values, 2 into g square, 2 root 2 whole square. Here 2g is equal to 4 root 2, then g is equal to 2 root 2. 2 root 2 whole square minus 1 into minus 42 by a into a plus b. 1 into 1 plus 49. Now this is the pair of straight line equation. Now we compare this equation with ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Then we get these values. Now replacing the values here, then we get this is equals to 2 root. 2 root 2 whole square is equal to 8. 8 plus 42 is equal to 50. 50 by 50. So answer is equal to 2 into 1. That is equals to 2. That is the last option. Sum number 14. Equation of the straight line parallel to x plus 2y minus 5 is equal to 0 and at the same distance from the point 3 comma 2. So the question is, one straight line is given here. This is the line x plus 2y minus 5 is equal to 0. And what is the equation of the line parallel to this one? Now what is the equation of the line parallel to this one? X plus 2y plus k is equal to 0. And also the second condition is the two lines have the same distance from the point 3 comma 2. Given that the distance from this point to the given line is equal to the distance from this point to the required length. The two distances are equal. That is the given data. So first, finding the two distances and equating both of the values. Now what is the perpendicular distance from the point to this line? Ax1 plus by1 plus c by square root of a square plus b square. That is, replacing the point in this equation, 3 plus 4 minus 5 by square root of a square plus b square, 1 plus 4, that is equals to 5, is equal to, now what is the distance from this point to this line? Again replacing the point in the line equation, 3 plus 4 minus 3 plus 4 plus k by root 5. Now, cut the number root 5 here. Then what is this value? Mod 7 minus 5, that is under modulus becomes 2, is equal to k plus 7. That is, the value of k plus 7 is equal to plus or minus 2. That is, k plus 7 is equals to plus 2 and k plus 7 is equals to minus 2. That is, the value of k is equal to minus 5 and the value of k is equal to minus 9. Now replacing these values in the line equation, then the line becomes x plus 2y minus 5 is equal to 0 or x plus 2y minus 9 is equal to 0. Now what is the answer? In the options we have the equation x plus 2y minus 9 equal to 0. This answer is not given in the options. So this is the correct answer. That's all. Next, sum number 15. If the straight line drawn through the point P root 3 comma 2 making an angle pi by 6 with the x axis meets the line root 3x minus 4y plus 80 equal to 0 at the point Q, then what is PQ distance? So given that the straight line drawn through the point P root 3 comma 2, so this is the straight line that passes through the point P root 3 comma 2 makes an angle pi by 6 with the x axis. Suppose this is the x axis. Given that the angle is equal to pi by 6 and meets the second straight line. Also another line is given. This is the second straight line. The equation is root 3x minus 4y plus 8 is equal to 0. Straight line meets the second line at the point Q. Then what is the distance PQ? That's a given question. So first I take the distance is equal to r here. So this is the given data. The straight line passing through the point P root 3 comma 2 makes an angle pi by 6 with the x-axis, and this line meets the second straight line root 3x minus 4y plus 8 equal to 0 at the point Q. Then what is the distance PQ? So first I take that the distance PQ is equal to R. So this point is equals to x1, y1. Now what is the formula for finding the Q point here? Q is equal to formula. Here we find the coordinates of the point by using the formula x1 plus r cos theta, y1 plus r sin theta. So here we can find the coordinates of this point by using this one. Now replacing the values, x1 is equal to root 3. There is no r value, and theta is equal to pi by 6, and cos pi by 6 is equal to root 3 by 2. And y1 value 2 plus r into sin 30 value 1 by 2. Now this is the point. Now clearly here the point Q lies on this line. That is, replacing this point in the line equation means writing the line equation here, root 3x minus 4y plus 8 equal to 0, and substituting this point in this line equation. That is, root 3 into root 3 plus r into root 3 by 2 minus 4 into 2 plus r into 1 by 2 plus 8 is equal to 0. Now multiplying the values here, root 3 into root 3, 3 plus root 3 into 3r, root 3 into root 3r by 2, 3r by 2 minus 8 minus 2r plus 8 is equal to 0. That is, here 8 and 8 gets cancelled, 8 and minus 8 gets cancelled. That is 3 plus 3r minus 4r by 2. Just doing LCM to these two terms here is equal to 0. That is, 3 minus r by 2 equal to 0 means 3 is equal to r by 2. Therefore, the value of r is equal to 6. That's all. This is the answer. That is the third option.